Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. Warp over to Snowpeak, transform into a human, because we have a minigame to play. Well, we're actually gonna play it twice, but still, we gotta play it for a heart piece. So let's do it! Look who is back up here! It is Yeto and Yeta. Long time since we meet, life feeling better, nice weather for sleds! You try, yes I will! So let's race! If you want to slow down, pull back on the control stick. If you want to speed up, push forward. Swing the Wii remote to whip out your sword, and you can use your sword to stun him, a la Mario Kart style like that. But that's pretty much unnecessary in this first race because he is so slow. You shouldn't have any trouble beating him whatsoever, especially since you have been through this course before and on that dry run to get to the Snow Peak ruins themselves, and that is exactly where we're racing to, actually. And I'm gonna try to jump across the tops of these trees just for fun! Yes! Yes! And, oh, I missed the third one, that's too bad. Too bad, you don't have to take those trees at all to beat Yeto. But it's just fun to do that for the heck of it. And oh geez, no ice structures in my way, thank you. And I'm gonna take it nice and easy. I'm not gonna try and cut the corner too tightly because he is lagging very far behind me. It is quite literally a racing game sort of situation in that you can see his red dot down there is him, and I am tracked by the yellow arrow, very similar to racing game structures where you can see where people are on the map. And we are almost at the finish line. Oh no 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 no. Okay, good. We made it. Woo! How did she get here? She got here fast. Well, he's delighted that I won, but he had a good time. And that I will do because that is what will give me the heart piece. But it's not a rematch with him per se. It's actually going to be a race with her. That's going to be pretty interesting, but we got to warp back over there. I didn't show you the warp location, though, in this entire walkthrough yet, did I? Just go over here. Snow Peak top. There you go. Let's go! I'm going to have to transform back into a human, but whatever. Race number two starts soon. Go, 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 go. Ah, this place is so beautiful at night. The ice glows with bloom. All right, now talk to his wife, Yetta. You beat husband. You good. You race me. Yes, I will. And she is the queen of the mountaintop. She has more agility. She moves faster than him in general. Just look at her go. She just zips all around all over the place. And try and stay ahead of her, but you're probably going to have to use the overpass shortcut, as peeps call it. I will show you how to use that, and hopefully I won't mess it up because it's kind of tricky to use. I'm going to try and stay as far ahead of her as I possibly can, just keep it nice and simple. Clear ice keys out along the way, and maybe I'll try and jump across the top of the trees again just for fun. Whee! Oh, I made one! Made two! Oh, I made all three, but I missed the purple rupee, and look how fast she got. She's so fast, she got ahead of me. Now go up here, and yeah, this is the issue that she has over you, is that if you don't take this shortcut, you are pretty much doomed. Oh god, oh god, oh god, I do not like this. It is so stressful. Okay. Oh, no, 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 please, dear lord, no. And now I have to restart it from the beginning. That was a pretty good run, though. I'm surprised I did that well. Alright. Attempt number two. Let's go. This race doesn't take all that long per run, so I don't think I'm gonna do any cuts unless this gets, like, excessively long. Like, I do way, way too many mishaps, so to speak, and it gets a little bit too repetitive. Alright. I can do it. That was a really, really good run there, I have to say. I'm surprised I really did that well. Alright, no touching walls. No touching baths. Get your sword out, just in case. Pop the gap. Attack like crazy in case they get in the way, but really they don't get in the way that much. I believe Yeto and Yeta can kill the enemies as well if... Oh, she got across them. She's going to be way ahead of me now. But yeah, they can sort of clear the way if they are ahead of you. But, oh, no. Jeez, dear lord, stop popping against the walls. No. I can't. No, dear lord. Okay, I got my control back. But I think she might be too far ahead of me. Maybe not. Maybe I'll be okay here. I'm gonna go up here because it's a little bit faster. It cuts the corner. I think I'm okay. Wait, don't touch the wall. Don't touch the walls. Okay, I got this. No. Oh, thank you. She pushed me ahead. Oh, I was worried that she's gonna knock me over or something like that. Oh, but I made it. Oh, yes. You slimmer than husband. Maybe that's it. It could be my aerodynamic skills. Well, aerodynamic body type. But anyway, you get a piece of heart for your troubles. And there's only two left in the entire game, and they're both in the next dungeon. So you can pretty much do other stuff that you know, you don't have to look for any other heart pieces around the area. As long as I'm here, I should probably get this. Transform into a wolf up here, and you're going to find that there is... I believe you can... Where can I go across? I'm trying to find the spot. Where? Because there's a Poe around this area. I forgot how to get to it. I was going to enter the building to like reset their things, but... Where is the thing that I'm looking for here? Was it up here? I thought I looked around the snow peak before. Maybe that's what I'm thinking of, is that I looked around the snow peak area before and I thought that I may have missed something up there on another run that I wasn't thinking of. And you get what I mean. It's one of those things where I did something before and I thought it was correct. Ah, that's the one I'm looking for. Because you have to take that path in order to get to this pole. There we go. Finish her off. There you go! Now, the next thing that I'm going to be doing in this part, just to finish her off, is the gold bugs. I'm gonna show a little clip of the one that I got back at Hyrule Field there, as I'm chattering over it. There are 24 in the game. I made a mistake earlier by saying that there was 20. But, yeah, there's 24 of them, and I intend on cutting over to each of them. So, what I'm gonna do here now, that you've seen that clip, is... Oh, there's no warp spot over at the Faron Province. Fine, I'll warp here, and then I'll walk over to where that bug was, and then... Yeah, I'll see you over there. And we are here! This is where the first... Whoa, wait, it's actually back over here? Really? I thought once you catch them, you don't have to... Oh. I mean, I thought once you catch them, they won't appear there again. Well, I guess I can show it in the same video after all. Here is the male beetle once again. Because, you know, why not? Okay, now... It always seems like that there is a male and female version of the same bug in the same area. And as an example, I'm going to go over to here and show you what I mean. It is somewhere around this area. I think it is up on that tree. You definitely want your Gale Boomerang out, because it's very handy for getting out of reach bugs here. And yeah, that's definitely... Ah! How dare you! How dare you ruin my bug hunt! Okay, lock on to the beetle, and it'll grab onto it and bring it toward... Whoa, no, I want beetle. Beetle Adventure Racing. Pick up. There we go. There we go. See, the other one was the male beetle. This one is the female beetle. They're both in the same area, as I said. And that's a common pattern with the bugs in this game. So, I'm gonna warp over to the next location and collect the next pair of bugs. Warping to Kakariko again! What? Okay, I'm gonna stop with that now. So what you wanna do here is transform into a human, of course. And there's one at the graveyard. I might as well get that since I'll be passing by this building anyway and I don't wanna go back and whatnot. So I'm going to flop over to the graveyard. As I said, two pairs are typically in the same area, so why not grab both at the same time? So here we are. Where was that? You can hear the twinkle of the gold bugs, but I don't know their locations offhand. I thought there's one like around here. Hear that? Where is that gold bug? First, I'm gonna get rid of you guys because you're gonna get in my way like no other critters before. Dang flock of crows. Where is... Oh, I see the bug, but I gotta get rid of these guys first. Come on. Boop. Unless they just keep coming at you, that would be pretty annoying. But you know what? Screw it. I'm gonna go run over and grab this, which is the male ant. Okay, that's another one. And now we're gonna go over to that completely empty building. Well, it's not completely empty, but it is, you know, there's no inhabitants of that building. I forgot which one it was, though. Because I'm just gonna have to try buildings until I find the one that I'm looking for. I think it's on this side, actually. Maybe it was this one? Maybe? Could be? I think it is. And okay, we are here. And if you knock... I can hear it twinkling. I think it's behind this thing, actually. Maybe what I'm supposed to do is knock over the cabinet. No, I don't think that's it. Maybe I'm just supposed to open the cabinet? Can I open the cabinet? I hear it around this area. I forgot the location. No? Oh, wait. It's on the floor? I didn't see that at all. Or at least I didn't notice it. Okay, there's the female ants. Next location. Let's warp over to Kakariko Village. Village. Kakariko Gorge for the next pair of bugs here. I hear it's so much easier to see the gold bugs at night. It's somewhere around here. In fact, I can hear it twinkling. Maybe I should get back into human form because I can't collect it as a wolf. Where is my bug? Wait, it's on the ground? How do I keep missing these things? And it's a pill bug! Delightful. Okay, now the other one should be, if I recall, this way. I don't think I've showed you this part of the gorge before. Well, maybe I have when I was exploring for stuff. I'm thinking it was around here. Maybe. Sucks when you can't remember stuff. Unless it's one of those things that I'm missing again. Is it on the back of the tree? Or on the tree? How about I kill you in the meantime, just for the fun of it? Ah, that was fun. Boop. Where was... No, it couldn't be this far away. Is it? No, that's it's not a gold bug on the wall there. Wait. Is it in this grass somewhere, which is why I didn't see it? I hear the twinkle. I'm in the right area then. Yeah! Where are you, my shiny buddy? Wait, is that... Was that it right there? Yeah, I guess it was in the grass then. Gimme! Woohoo! The female pill bug! As expected, because, you know, they're both in the same general area. Next set of bugs, we go! Since I always seem to favor this warp at Castletown, well, here you go. Alright, so we are looking for butterflies now. There should be... They flutter around... Like, did I hear the twinkle? Is that it over there? They flutter around like grassy, flowery areas. Yeah, there it is. See, like, they like to go somewhere where they are well hidden, but yet still flutter about happily. And, oh, come on, let me grab you. There we go. Yay! It's the male butterfly! Alright, one more to go. And I remember seeing that, I mean, as we passed through here a few times, down this way, and it should still be fluttering around. Don't shoot me, thank you. Maybe, was it up? Maybe it was up there? Ah, it was up there. Well, I remember seeing that spot. All right, and pick her up. There we go, the female butterfly, also hidden within the flowery grass here. All right, next spot. Since I can't warp here, you just have to take the east path away from Castletown here, follow this path over to Lake Hylia. You should know this path by now. And we are looking for two bugs, and I tried to cut the corner there a little too tight, but that is my fault. Okay, listen carefully for the twinkles. They're around here somewhere. Wait, what is that? Something that is bombable? Maybe? Why not? What is my prize? Oh, a bunch of blue rupees. Why not? So let's pick them up. Alright. Wait, is that it? Right? I thought I seen the gold or the bug. Ah, it's so hard to see them during the daytime. I hope it turns nighttime soon here. In here, maybe? By the way, you can really notice the difference in sound in Link's great spin when he's at full health, as opposed to the normal spin attack. Wait, did I not check the arch itself yet? Because I seen that there was some, yeah, vines up there. Oh, I hear it! Okay, it is somewhere around here. What's the point of those vines, anyway? Okay, it's definitely somewhere around here. Maybe that was just to hint where that bug was, and it's on the other side. That's why those vines are... Ah, there it is! Thank you, Nighttime Glow. Gimme. No! I can grab you from there, right? Yeah. He didn't even reach up to grab it. He just grabbed in front of it, and it just magically appeared in his hands there. Alright, so we got the mantis. Now, on the other side of the bridge, which I still haven't shown you yet, but now I'm going to show you, is the other bug that I'm looking for. It should be a lot easier to locate now that it's at nighttime. And I'll show you this side of the bridge as well. It's not all that interesting, I suppose, but it's still different enough to be worth showing you the pathway, I suppose. It leads to the south part of Hyrule Field there. But I don't remember where the bugs are, and that's my issue. I just know they're general locations. Oh, wait, was that it there? It is. And they're pretty well hidden, too. So it's definitely useful to get them at night there. There we go, and there's the female mantis. Now I'm going to walk down this pathway and show you the rest of it, just because. And there isn't really all that much more to show here. I don't think I've been through here before in my playthrough just yet. Well, walkthrough, not playthrough. Playthroughs have less information. Oh, geez, sniper. Oh, bombable thing. I'll pop that there and hide. I think I'm too close. No, no, I'm not. Okay. And it's a pretty linear path through here. It's just got a couple of sniping bokoblins up there. It's no big deal whatsoever. And then he eventually leads you to its own little path there. See how this is very small area that's glowing on the map there? It just changed there. There's this really weird split path here. I don't get this at all. Just look at this. It loops around like this, then you hop off, and you can climb back up. But what's... why? I guess it's to be less, you know, straight and linear like the other spot, but... I don't know, it always seemed weird to me. And here we are. This is the other gate that was closed. It is now open. I don't think I even showed you this part of Hyrule Field, my walkthrough. I've been really, really... I've been staying on the track of things to keep things as organized and as smooth as possible. And yeah, we are back at this part of the field, which I'm sure you've seen before. So I'm just going to flop over to the next spot. Day two with working on this. Warp over to the Bridge of Elden. And I'll get this one first. On this side, you can pretty much see it glowing from here on the inner arch. Oops. Transform to a human. And I'm going to snipe our sniper buddy here before I get too close and he becomes annoying. Alright, you've seen the other bug on the other end of this bridge, so it's no big deal. But, gotcha. And it is a phasmid. Now, we go over to the other side. We need our claw shots for this, if you recall. And, alright, maybe I'm gonna have to... Can I shoot him from this far away? Yes, I can. At least I think that was a hit. No, wait, I may have missed. I think that little spark was me hitting the wall there. It was just so far away. Yeah, there we go. Alright, claw shots! And you remember that path that led to that lava area thingy? Yeah, go up there with the claw shots, follow the wall, and then you will be able to get the bug. I am not close to this target again. What is with me and not being able to judge the distance between me and this target, anyway. Alright, let's get the boomerang. That is one depressed cuckoo. Yeah, so I walked over to Kakariko Village again because I needed to go to the north area of Kakariko Field, and what we are looking for is two more bugs, of course, but where are they? Oh, jeez, you guys are here? I think the one that I'm looking for is over by this wall here, maybe. It's somewhere around in this general area, unless I've already... ow. Unless I've missed it, or maybe it's further down, but I know it is somewhere around this area, and it should be glowing. Wait, is that it up over there? No, that's not it. Yeah. I don't really care that much about the damage over here, because just look how many hearts I have. I mean, come on now. Let's look at things realistically here. Oh, dang it, daybreak is coming. That's gonna make things harder to look for the bugs again. Wait, is that? Oh, like that's a crack in the wall. Wait, is that it there? Just hanging out in the... yeah, it is. That's what I'm looking for. And now we go pick her up. It is a grasshopper! I thought it was gonna be more hidden than that, which is why I use like locations to get myself to move over to certain spots. And you know what I'm gonna do? I haven't showed that path over there on the map. You see that that part on the bridge there that I haven't been through yet. That was the spot that I said I haven't showed back when I did the hot spring water quest thing. So why not go through there and just give you a little tour? The other bug is around like this area on the map, if I recall correctly, somewhere. But I'm not going there just yet. I want to get all the paths out. Open on the, I'm going to pick up your arrow just because, steal your arrow, just because I want to get all the map drawn out for you. This is yet another linear path like that one that you've seen. It was over here on the map. The daybreak music. So gorgeous. So iconic. I can blow this up. Blowing up stuff is fun! Yay! And we are almost at the other part of Hyrule Field here. And yeah, we are now here. If you don't notice it, this is, see that over... See that over there? That is Kakariko Village, if I'm not mistaken. And yeah, you should know where you are by now. Wait, what is this? This is bombable. So thus it will be bombed. Man, you can get a lot of rupees from just bombing the random boulders you see around this place. Alright, I'm going to go cut back over to the other field and get the other bug. And here we are, repassing over this bridge here into the field, and I'm going to keep going straight. And I'm going to try something here that I never thought of before. I wonder if it's easier to find golden bugs when you darken the screen like that with your senses. That might make things a whole lot easier to find. Maybe. I'm not sure about that. Wait, is that... It does make things easier during the daytime. Look at that dot. Right in distance there. Oh my god, that would be practically invisible if I didn't use my wolf senses there during the daytime. And there's the female grasshopper. Sweet! Next spot, we go. Why not warp to the sacred grove next? These next two are really, really easy. The first one, I've showed you this before, actually, on my... pass through in this area. Was it? Ah, there it is. Transform into a human, of course. Get ye ol' boomerang. And bring it towards you. This very, very slow critter here. Oops, I want to show it in first-person view here. Yep, it's a snail. A very shiny snail. Likely glossed with its sliminess, and that's the male version. The female version is still in the same area, but not quite. You've actually got to go back in time to get the other snail and bring it back to the present time by going inside the Temple of Time. And I said time a bunch of times there, but that is okay. Ah, welcome back. But we won't be here for long. Go around this. I already showed you the location of this one as well. Wow, I'm getting kind of violent there with the pots. I'll just put that one down carefully. And there's the female snail. You know what? I'll break that pot too. What the heck? And next location. But we gotta get out of here first. Warp to the Gerudo Mesa next. And get to searching. I believe they're both around the same area, both the female and male version of this bug. They are so hard to spot in the desert. So I'm definitely going to be using my wolf powers here. I'm surprised I never thought about that before in my bug hunts. Is this one bombable? I think it's bombable. I'm just going to blow it up just because... If it is bombable, no, it's not bombable. It seemed like it was, though. That's why I attempt it. Alright, so we are searching. Blindly, practically. Wait. could have swore I heard it. This is gonna be so annoying. I think I've gone too far, actually. Yeah, because I think once I plop down into this area, it's rather hard to get out of. Wait, wait. There's a digging spot here. Oh, this is for Poe's later, isn't it? Oh, no, wait, maybe it's not. There's definitely a digging spot here for Poe's. Oh, it's the rare chew jelly. Or another rare chew jelly. Go inside. Go inside menu. I'm gonna grab some of that just for the heck of it. Drink! Hurry! And see if I can pick up the rare chew. Oh, come on. I lost the chew again. What a waste. Well, I suppose if I leave this area and then come back to it, I'll be able to have another shot at it. But seriously, what a waste. The only thing that's like worthwhile in this place for the rare chew jelly, because that's certainly what it seems like, just like that other one back at the snow peak. I think I'm gonna leave these critters be, because I'm not seeing anything of importance. I'm gonna warp out and then dig back in for that gold chew, or the rare chew jelly. Because why not? Since I didn't really show it, I mean, I didn't show myself getting some of it before. And dig back in. Jeez, I'm burning a lot of time in the desert here. Hopefully it'll be back around here. Oh, there it is. And then we scoop. There we go. Sparkly! It's rare chew jelly! You can replenish all hearts and briefly boost attack strength, just like the fairy tears. Alright, let's get out of here, and I'm gonna warp back over to the other spot. Because I went down a spot that I shouldn't have jumped down to, I'm pretty sure. So let's just do that really quick, and continue exploring. See, I think the bugs are like in this area, and I shouldn't be where I am now. But that was definitely worth checking out, because I was able to show you another rare chew jelly location, I guess. Okie dokie. Now, where are the bugs? Where are the bugs? They're somewhere around here. I know that. Whoa, whoa! Hello? There's one. Nope, I don't want to. No. Don't Z-target the things I don't want you to Z-target. Oh, wait. Oh, it's flying around. Thank you. Yes, there we go. It is a dayfly! And now you need the other version. Somewhere. Okay, so I'm just gonna get out of this crevice and look around, preferably from a higher vantage point. No, don't. Well, I guess that's okay if you loop around me. It doesn't do any harm, I suppose. Where is that other one? This whole part is pretty much gonna be saying, where is the bug? Just replace the bug name every time I say that, and there you go. It's gotta be around here somewhere. Is it somewhere in the air? Because it's a flying bug. And when you're in wolf sense mode, you can really tell where the bugs are. Maybe it's down one of these cracks or something. Oops. You know, these trenches here? Because the other one was in a trench similar to this, and yeah. So maybe all trenches are not the same, per se? Like, maybe if I hop down here and then explore the area. These take so long to get. Whoops. Well, that's not good. Where does that take me back to anyway? Oh, all the way back over here, okay. That's not that bad. What I'm thinking is that it's not in the area that I thought they were, but maybe they're the other one is fluttering around the outer perimeter or something like that. Guess we will see soon enough. Maybe. Just careful not to hop down any more gaps. Dang fissures. One hit kill in Pokemon, providing it hits with its low accuracy. Still looking. Maybe it's around this rock, just because it is a landmark. It's also pretty annoying to go through here when it's, you know, the daytime, because it camouflages the bugs. Wait, is that? There it is! There it is! There's the other one! Grab it! No, don't fly higher than me. Come back down. Gimme. Yes! Yes! what they mean about the collection screen is if you go in this menu and you look at your gold bugs, and you can see the pairs of bugs here. This is the one I already gave to Agatha. See, it's got a bug mark next to it, the little butterfly there. And here are the day flies that I just got in both male and female versions. Male are green, pink are female. Alright, let's go to the next location. I am tired of this desert, although I'm going to have to come back here for Poes later. But still, I am tired of it for now. Alright, I'm going to warp over to this part of Hyrule Field once again. Yeah, that's the spot east of Castletown. And what I'm going to do is take the south exit from the town and scare people along the way just because it's going to be fun. And there's two bugs that you can find at the area of town. Oh man, I am not looking forward to editing this video later. There's going to be so much micromanaging. Because I keep cutting to different locations, and I'm gonna... Oh, man. Don't worry, I'm just a harmless wolf passing through town to get some bugs. I don't eat humans, I eat bugs. Okay, that's not true. Alright, so it's turning nighttime, although this bloom is going to give me tons of trouble. But I think the first bug is in these planter pots off on the sides of town here. Well, one of them is... I just gotta look around carefully. Wolf senses really, really help. Maybe it's down one level. Oh, I see one. Or is that lighting? No, that's lighting. Dang it! I didn't see one. It was lighting. Oh, there's a pole. Why not grab you? Just because I'm here. This is another thing. I'm gonna have to look for poles in the clips to add the... pole boxes too, you know, little custom graphics boxes that I made here. Oh, that's the first one. That was the one I think I pointed this one out earlier in the walkthrough. It is a female ladybug. I clicked through that way too fast, but I hope you've seen that. If you didn't, well, just rewind the video and pause when I accidentally clicked through that. is that the other one that I'm looking for? I think that is the other one that I'm... Yeah, that is. Okay, awesome. Yeehaw! The male ladybug! And I'll give you extra amount of time to see this screen. Just because, you know, I clicked through the other one too quickly. There you go, you should be pleased. Alright, next location. I warped over to the Castletown area over there, as I usually do. And, oh, I think I see the first bug already. And anyway, I went north from there to this part of the field. Because there's no warp point over here, unfortunately. I'm gonna... take care of you, Lizafulse. Because you're just there to be there. And is it possible to grab the bugs and get it instantly in my hand with it? No, I can't. So it's very similar to using the Gale Boomerang. And that seems a little bit painful for those poor bugs, so I'm just gonna do it with the boomerang way. Although that very, very hard shell on it might be helpful for it, you know, to survive such an assault. Alright. Is that... No, that's a Poe. Might as well grab that Poe as long as I'm passing through here. I was gonna say, I don't recall there being a bug over here. But first, I'm gonna kill you, because you're gonna get in the way of me killing the Poe. And there we go. Sense. Come down here. Fight me like a ghost. And another one bites the dust. I'm still gonna have to come through here to get other Poes. But, you know, as long as I'm here, why not? Oh, it's way harder to fight these guys when you're in wolf form. Ah, whatever. The other one that I think is in this area, I think it is somewhere up here. Maybe. Was it on the overpass area? Because I know there is that pathway that leads around it, and I don't see any glow from here. Oh no, it's raining! My coat! I'm gonna smell like a wet dog. Quite literally. Oh, I see it! I see it! Whoop! Oh, the Wolf Link does not do very much damage with its normal attacks. Unless you do this. That's pretty effective, though. But I can't use... I mean, I can't be in wolf form to get this bug. Alright, let's lock on. Pull it towards us. And... No. Gotcha! And there's the female stag beetle. Just a few more to go. Zora's Domain is the next spot. And I'm going to hop down here because this isn't where the bug is. I just used it as a warp location. And hop down here. Keep going. I think you've seen the bug as I was falling down here, actually. If you look up there, unless that was a Poe that I seen. Oh, it is a Poe. No, wait, that is the bug. Alright, here's bug number one. Gotta wait for it to come down towards me. It does eventually. Unless I'm gonna have to claw shot it down here to get a little closer. Oh, come on, you were able to reach the one on the Hyrule Bridge, but not the other one? Come on now, man. Alright, the other one isn't quite in the same area. It is at Upper Zora's River. So it is kind of in the same area because they're connected by the same river, but it's not quite. So these two here might puzzle you if you don't know better. Although you might have seen the other bug as we passed through here before. See that? It's right in plain sight. At Iza's Rapids Ride. Oops. And let's get it closer. Yep. Not close enough. Ah, there we go. Now, get it. This is the last bug. Yes! Yeah! How do you like them apples? I see a Poe over there. I wonder if I should... I'll get that later. I'm tired of going out of my way for Poes. Alright, back to Castle Town. Let's give them to Agatha. Okay, here's her rates for bugs. For the first bug you give her, she gives you a larger wallet. After that, what she does is, for every bug you give her, it is 50 rupees she will give you, and for every completed pair, she will give you 100 rupees. So, for every pair of bugs, you will get 150 rupees out of it. I was going to combine this side quest with the, my fangirls. Can I transform here? Oh, dang it. Oh, that's why, because these guys are here. Dang it! I wanted to say hi to my fangirls. So, I was attempting in my planning... Where can I transform? Maybe I should have done that outside before I came in here. So, as I keep interrupting myself, my plan was to combine it with... Seriously? Was to combine it with the Malamart quest. You know, when you had to pay off the extreme 2,000 rupee thing that I thought was, well, 2,000 rupees, as I said. But once I was thrown completely off by the hot spring quest, dropping it by 1,800 rupees, I was like, well, what am I going to do with this extra money now, you know, for the gold bug quest? And I guess there's roll goal. But still. Why? Why? Why is it so hard? Can I transform? Do I really have to leave town nowadays to... Fine. Fine. Jesus Christ. I probably sounded really whiny there, but whatever. And how's my fangirls doing? And then they leave town. Or will they? Will they come back for me, or will they... Yeah, they went that way. Okay. Alright, now I'm going to go over and hit my face in the wall, which is a pretty regular occurrence. I'm going to go over to Agatha and reap the rewards. Wait, are you... Yeah, this is it. Agatha's castle. Oh, and I should show you something that's pretty funny as well, as long as I'm here. First, I'm going to give her the other beetle for the pairing.
Have you brought a bug for Princess Agatha's ball?
Why, yes, I have. So yeah, I'm going to give her the pair, and she is going to give me 100 rupees for it, because I completed a pair.
Oh boy, who's your friend? You really little female beetle, aren't you? You little cutie? You little beetle, what do you say?
Oh, again as a pillow. Poor beetles. And she gives me 100 rupees, just as promised. And I have all 22 of them, as you can see in my inventory screen. Ah, yes. Wait, why did I even bother showing that? Oh, I didn't show the mirror shards before, did I? I should say I didn't point them out. Now, this is what I mean about there's something funny. If you leave the place, I know you have bugs. She can sense that you have bugs that you haven't given her yet. She definitely has quite the connection with bugs, I have to say. Okay, let's give her the other 22. I don't know if she's going to have anything else to say other than using them as a pillow. I don't remember, actually. I guess we're going to see once we start giving other pairs. Yeah. So let's start with the upper left corner. Mm-hmm. Please don't. I went through a lot of trouble to get these things. And there's the 50 rupees, but I didn't complete the pair yet. Looking for a partner, and that's why she gives you 100 for each pair of male and female, because she wants couples, basically. Maybe she says something different for each, for each type, but not for the second one. And there's 100 rupees, and my wallet is going to be completely full. Will I still be able to give her bugs? I think I will. I don't need any more money, actually, for the rest of this game here, aside from roll goal, so... Well, I guess you now have a new kitchen companion. There we go. Yeah, I'm not even gonna worry about rupees at this point, because I am loaded. Onions, delightful, good. 100 rupee for the pair. Alright, let's get to the next one here. I wanna see what else she has to say to us here. What do you have to say about butterflies? Mm-hmm. Maybe you should just stick with the foundation. Alright, next. Actually, I don't think any girl needs to wear makeup or anything like that, because it's kind of fake if you ask me, but that's just my opinion. And there we go. Alright, what else do you have to say about the other bugs? Wow, I've still got 16 more to give you. Good lord. I wonder how long this part is going to be, because this part just might be the longest part I've ever made. That sounds painful to that poor bug. Because it's not like they're that flexible. Alright, next one. Da-da-da-da-da, yada yada yada. Let's go! Go, go, go! Okay, start the next column. Bows, delightful. It may seem like all these rupees are going to waste, but I seriously am done with all the rupee side quests in the game, aside from roll goal, so... Alright, what do you have to say about dayflies? Again, that sounds kind of painful to the bug. I feel kind of bad about giving her these bugs now that I think about it more, even though that we're going to get a larger wallet for giving her all of them. Because this is like bug abuse if we just give them to her, because she doesn't seem to be... Although she says she just wants to take them and use them as pillows and tie them into things, and... So maybe she doesn't mean that she's actually going to do it. That's what I'd like to believe. Because it just sounds a little bit too brutal for these poor bugs. Alright, you gonna use these beetles as a pillow too? Why would something sharp feel good? Maybe she likes acupuncture or something like that? Alright, 11 more. So much A button pressing. Alright, 10 more. 10 more. Go, go, go. Alright, what do you have to say about the ladybugs? You know, a male ladybug is kind of misleading based on their name for obvious reasons. Okay, this one's okay, I suppose, because it's like riding an animal of sorts. And she said if she's smaller, so she clearly acknowledges that she would squish them in her current state. Yes, I have many more. Alright, you aren't going to say anything new about the ladybug, yeah. And I think I'm going to end off this part, because this is really going on for a while here. Alright, grasshoppers. Gonna tickle torture those poor grasshoppers now, all these poor things. Well, I hope this ball goes well. Yeah, orange rupee. Yeah. Look at all these rupees going to waste. But I say I don't need any more. Alright. Yeah, yes it is. I guess that's not so bad, but I think that she'd make those poor bugs dizzy through time, and yeah, that still sounds like bug abuse. I mean, granted, you know they can roll up in a ball for their protection, but... poor bugs. They just don't stand the chance against her. Actually, from the looks of things, after you fill up this room with bugs, I'll show you what it looks like. It seems like that they live a pretty happy life, because they, wait, what did that say? It might actually be a female. Ah! they are referencing that snails could possibly change their gender, and that's something that certain species can do. What? That sounds like some sort of fetish, if you ask me. I'm not judging or anything like that, but... And does it say the same thing about the female one if I select it? Like, it'll actually say it might be a male version. Because they can change gender multiple times throughout their life to breed and whatnot. And, well... Maybe it's very comforting for snails to be that gooey. So maybe it's not that bad after all. No, as I said, I'm just joking around. I don't judge that sort of thing. Although I am pretty germophobic, so yeah. What? Are you falling in love with the dragonflies now? Alright, one more to go. And then I will be getting the prize that we have all been waiting for! By giving a ton of bugs to her. And she says the same thing regardless if it's female or not. And, yep! Completed! Oh man, if these bugs breed, it's just going to be an explosion of gold bugs everywhere. And there's the giant wallet. Then it quite literally is a giant wallet that can hold up to 1,000 rupees. That is awesome. Although she doesn't fill it up and you can't do anything with the overflow. I'm going to climb up here right over the bug because it doesn't seem to mind. And just to give you a overhead view of this place, because I said I would. You can see them all on the walls and stuff like that, fluttering around happily. And they're like this throughout the rest of the game, so she doesn't actually abuse the bugs. I was just joking around about that. She's definitely a big bug enthusiast, that is for sure. Right, let's go down to the lower level. Her house is actually pretty much designed to be a bug's paradise. You can see bugs on the ceiling. There is a tree for them to climb around on the ground floor that she built her house around. Stuff like that. Leaves for them to walk around in. So they actually do have a good home after all. And with that, I'm going to end off this part because it is going to be crazy long. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part. Wait, I should exit the door so there's a nice transition.